Hello, explorers. I hope all of you are doing well. Today here we are to discuss something all of us are fascinated about. Yes, the sky and beyond. As rightly stated by Plato, astronomy is some subject that compels the soul to look upwards and leads us from this world to another. Very true. We look up and always think, what is going up there? Which is the closest star? And we know all these facts about this beautiful starry night. But we should not only know facts, we should know the science behind it as well. Why? Because all of us are explorers here. Today we are going to understand small concepts in astronomy with the help of our two experts who have a vast experience in science and astronomy as well. I welcome Suyash Dake sir and Dinesh Nisang sir to guide us in this journey. Please, sir.
Good morning, everyone.
Hello, everybody. Now, henceforth or here onwards, we will be talking about something very unique, that is about astronomy and space, both together. The occasion that we are sharing this video with you or this live session with you is the launch of a special program by Kutuhal Sunday Science School Group. The program name is Sky and Space. That's a 10 session program occurring on every Sunday. But leave that apart. First, let us know something about sky and vis-a-vis space as well. See, we sometimes go to a planetarium to see sky around us. With amazed eyes, we look up, and with the projector, the operator shows you three-dimensional view of sky. You know the several stars rise in the eastern side, come up or maybe travel from the borders and go for setting on the other side. That's everyday experience for them, but we see it once in a planetarium. But don't you think that when you stand somewhere in the dark place on the earth, away from city, the polluted light of city, the sky over you itself is a planetarium, and you can watch that wonderful night with studded stars, a complete starry night, with that awe and a lot of insight that this field is a vast kind of field. That kind of feeling we always carry. Yes, indeed, it's very true. So, we have to learn about sky, how these stars follow some kind of pattern. Today, if some star rises at 6:30 in the evening, today, if it is 22nd of November, down the line, if you see sky, again on 22nd of November, after 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, 100 years, same star will rise from same eastern horizon at 6:30, even after several years, because these stars follow some pattern. We take orbit around ourselves, or we rotate around ourselves, and we also take orbit around the sun. So, exactly after 365 days, we have similar positions, but we'll discuss that once we actually go for more detailed discussion on this. But let us know that stars rise, stars set. So in a planetarium we see that. Can we really have a planetarium at home? Sounds impossible. But yes, why not? Let children or why children, anybody, do these kinds of simple planetariums. I'm just going to show you one like this. This black colored box has small holes made using a nail showing different positions of stars. And this is made free to rotate. This set as per latitude of your place so that we can exactly align to the axis of the earth. And as the time progresses, we can just turn it around and using some kind of umbrella or a squarish box, you can project these stars on some screen. Yes, it is not as perfect as a three-dimensional planetariums. They show you real shows. But nonetheless, this will trigger some kind of interest in you to understand that how sky rotates. So we are giving you an activity just to trigger that interest. And on the basis of this activity, naturally, we have to discuss a lot about how stars rise, how many stars can you see, why can't you see some stars which are so faint, or what is the resolving power, what is the distance of the stars from you. So many things we must learn while understanding basic concept of planetarium. So this is your star projector as one part of your program that I have just mentioned, sky and space. To give you a nutshell about this course before I proceed, this is a 10 Sunday program. Each Sunday will have some activity kit for child or even adults having a child in their brain to do some activity. Enjoy that, learn out of that, and there will be a thorough video theory giving a theoretical aspect of that concept. So one concept will be discussed in one video, share it with you on Saturdays. So comfortably you can see that video, do the activities. And on Sunday in the afternoon, we'll have a discussion session on same concept. So we'll share in very brief about that concept in 5-10 minutes. And there'll be question answers. If you have any questions, we should answer them. So that's the purpose of this entire program. Now you know that stars do follow a pattern, but there are some wanderers who don't obey that kind of routine. They don't exactly rise at same time on same day every year. They may keep changing their pattern of rising and setting. And these wanderers are called, yes, I think you all guessed it right, they are planets. So planets have different kind of orbits. So we will learn about planets as well. Let Dinesh share something about planets.
Yes, and the first question when you start studying astronomy is, what is the difference between stars and planets? So you know the answer, you write the answer. The celestial bodies has own light are called as stars, and celestial bodies, who don't have their own light, are planets. But how we can differentiate between stars and planets in our real sky? So when you go outside under starry sky, we see lot many stars. Basically for us, all are stars. They are shining bright. If you notice, there may be some difference of color. Some are reddish, some are whitish, some are bluish, some are orange. But how we can differentiate between stars and planets? Theoretically, as I told you, the wanderers, as sir told, wanderers are planets, or those who don't have own light are called as planets. But how we can identify planets in the real sky? Even today, if you go outside after sunset, what you see in the sky, if you notice yesterday or day earlier, you must have seen few bright things in the sky. In the western sky, on the zenith, zenith means the position on right top of your head, and in the eastern sky. Yes, there are planets right now in the sky. Today also you can witness, if you have a clear sky, you can see Jupiter, Saturn and Mars with your naked eyes. So these planets, they are visible in the sky from ancient times. We are studying the science of astronomy. If you ask me, I will say that we are studying astronomy since we were living in the forest, because at that time that was the only entertainment for us, and we set our routine life according to the rising and setting of sun, moon, and then after stars. So these planets, they not only revolve around the sun, we have questions in mind. Are there living things beyond our Earth or solar system? What are exoplanets? You will get all answers to these questions in this sky and space course. And there are some interesting facts. What is the day you wet for the most throughout the year? And that day is your birthday. And you have to wait for birthday for how many days? 365 days you wait for that single day. What if I tell you, you will have your two birthdays in single day? Amazed? Then on which planet you have to go to celebrate your two birthdays in a day? That is Venus. So there are so many facts about the planets. We are sending human space exploration missions on Mars very soon. By end of this, means by 2030, man will land on Mars. So all these things we have to study, and also I will show you this model as well. So this is, we call it as a 3D solar system. In the center we have sun here. So I'm just glowing the sun, and we can make such working models to understand the distance between sun and planets. Also, not only these planets, they also have satellites. They are called as natural satellites, as we have moon as our natural satellite. So Jupiter, Saturn, they also have their natural satellites in numbers. Like Jupiter has more than 63 satellites. Now recently, in last month, we saw that Saturn, natural satellites of Saturn, has increased than Jupiter. Basically, it is a kind of what you can say,
tug of war
happening between brother and sisters.
Yes.
They snatches their toys, and now I have more collection of toys. The same thing happening between Jupiter and Saturn. So many things are there, even a lot of meteors. We will learn all these things, what are meteors and planets, exoplanets, during this course. And we will make such beautiful working models. That is the most important thing, learning by doing. Because anyway, from very young age, you are looking at pictures of solar system. You have extra books. Apart from, though astronomy is covered in geography of your textbook, but still you read out of your interest. You search on internet about these things. So only reading, only learning is not important. Doing things by hand and presenting it to others also is a very good learning tool that every child should go through it. And now, what is next? Basically, when you are learning about these planets, in our calendar, for example, you love to fly kites. When you fly kites and why? That is Makar Sankranti. So what is Makar Sankranti? Normal case, you say that sun is entering into Makar. So what is that? What are these zodiacs? Or the many times you read your horoscope in the newspaper. So what are these zodiacal signs and constellations? I think we also have something on that as well.
Exactly. See, and now we know that planets are very nearby. They are as if our neighbors. But that neighbors alone doesn't make complete society. Few neighbors don't have a complete range of society. Complete society is all about people staying in that city at least. Same is true even for sky. These seven neighbors that Earth has that make up our solar system, including Sun and its eight, say, small planets. But you know that all of us, including Earth, all planets orbit around the Sun. And while orbiting around the Sun, we see different parts of sky. Some part of the sky is not visible because that goes exactly behind the Sun, and along with Sun it rises and it sets. So you can't see that. That zodiacal sign is not visible during that month. As Earth then moves forward, another sign becomes sign of the Sun for that month. And perhaps in English newspapers, you might be reading that Sun signs are given, where between this date and this date, the Sun is in that constellation. Now I have used the term constellation. Constellation is nothing but a visible group of stars. Not, they are not exactly together, but they are appearing together in one part of the sky. A very interesting phenomenon to read the sky. In 1929, formerly Astronomical Union zeroed down on 88 constellations dividing overall sky, of which some constellations are special because Sun appears to pass through them, or Sun blocks one constellation for some number of days of the year. So Sun does not pass through them, we pass through opposite side, so Sun appears to be on the backdrop of some constellation. Such 12 constellations are called as zodiacal constellations. Now one more, 13th is also added, that Ophiuchus, but that I am not considering now. 12 constellations normally we talk about. I'll just show you one interesting model. Take a look first. And don't forget that this is what you also will be making as a part of this course, to understand concept of zodiacal signs or zodiacal signs. So you will find that you can make this Earth orbit around the Sun by running on this motor.
Basically, it is a very beautiful model, and you have to make a lot of connections in this.
Okay, right now it is going clockwise, but normally it should go anticlockwise. Nothing wrong, we have to just interchange the wires. So these are 12 constellations. This is nothing but a band. So you can say this is a plane of ecliptic, that Sun's position and Earth's orbit around Sun. So that ecliptic I am trying to show you as a path of the Sun. So Sun changes its position from one place to other place as the Earth moves. That's the concept of zodiacal constellations. I'll just turn this off. We'll go for something different right now. Can you take this? See, we are very proud of a star by name Sun, as if Sun is the largest star of the universe. But not the fact. You will find there are stars which are thousands of times larger than the Sun. So many stars are much more in larger in size. Now if you know the names like Sirius, for example, or those who are using Hindu mythological names, Vyadha, that is larger, or if you say Antares, or one star from Vrishik or Scorpio, such stars are so large, hundreds of times larger than the Sun. So Sun is very ordinary star. And we know Sun being its closest to us. We also know that nearest star then would be 4.2 light years away. That means light also takes more than 4.2 years to reach to that star, or light from that star to reach to us takes more than 4.2 years. So Sun is very ordinary star. Can you imagine that if somebody looks from the universe towards the sun, he'll find a cluster of several stars like this, where sun is in the middle and there are 20 neighbors of sun surrounding around in all directions. So this is a model which you will be doing to understand which are the nearby prominent stars that sun enjoys company of. So sun is enjoying company of these 20 stars, nearby stars. However, there are quite a few other stars which are red dwarfs, which cannot be seen by eyes, naked eyes like that. So we have not included them into this. A concept learning of what is a star, how star produces energy, what is the life cycle of stars, how are they born, how do they die, what happens, what will happen when sun will die, what happens when a large star dies, do all stars become black hole? Of course no, but few stars finally become black holes. How exactly this happens, we will try to learn everything around it.
Yes, and basically a normal question of students is what are black holes, but there are so many things before you learn about black holes, and that all we are going to cover in
yes,
the course.
Exactly, and this is not just about making models, it is doing some activities and experiments as well. Take an example, lot of us have a question that how do we find out distance of a star when nobody can drive a car up to that star? How will you know distance of a star? And yes, there is a method called as a parallax method to find out distance of stars which are up to 400 light years from you. But 400 light years, not a very small thing. There is a concept called as parallax method. Using this method, we can know the angle of a star when Earth orbits around the sun. The angle will change because after 6 months, Earth will change its position. And if you take a look at the star, its background will change. As if I look at my hand by one eye closed, if I look using right eye, hand appears this way, using left eye, hand appears to shift. That's a parallax. So that method is used to understand distance of a star. We'll try to understand how such methods are used. So children, lot to be learned. And that is, I'll just share one interesting quote by Hubble. You know Edwin Hubble, that's a very famous name in astronomy. So perhaps you might have heard of Hubble telescope. That is something which is working for 20 years in space for mankind. Edwin Hubble had quoted once that equipped by 5 senses, man has explored the universe around him. I can say even women have explored universe around them or her, and that journey is called a science. So that is very important, that exploring using your 5 senses is journey of science. We want all of you, those who are 10 years and above, upper age has no limit, can join this program Sky and Space. So we have talked little about sky so far, but we know in recent 40-50 years of last, starting from 60s, space has become a buzzword, very important concept for all of us, space research, and India is also doing a
yes.
lot into that now.
Yeah, so basically as we are studying these things, we must have instruments. Recent last 400 years, we have instruments to observe the universe. Like sir rightly mentioned, Hubble Space Telescope. Whatever beautiful pictures you come across in books on internet, more than 90% images are captured by Hubble in space. Because there is no obstruction of clouds, day and night, even Hubble can take a picture of a star which is next to the sun. During daylight, we cannot see sky. We have to wait for night. But the tool, what we have today is a telescope. I think you are getting such a telescope in the course as well. You will be making this telescope. This is a refractor telescope. What we will be making, And space research means apart from telescope, we will go to read the night sky. So whenever you look up in the sky, we are giving you a such sky chart. And reading of such sky chart, basically planets, they change their position, but stars, they never change their position. Yes, that is because of our lifespan. We cannot see what is happening. If whatever you look at, actually you are looking at the past. Even you look at the sun, you are looking sun which is 500 second old. If something happens on sun, we will come to know after only 500 seconds. So when you look at any star, you look at that constellation or position of a star or a nebula, some hundred and thousand of years, what is happening there. So today, if something is happening there, we will come to know after 500,000 years. Till that, we are not living. So for us, this the pattern of stars, the pattern of constellations, which our ancestors saw, means as say that we can see lion. So when you see your horoscope or your zodiacal sign, say lion. So Leo, you can literally see a picture of Leo in the sky. Only thing you need to draw some imaginary lines to see that shape. And that is very interesting. Means you really don't need any kind of equipment. This is a 0 rupee hobby.
That's great.
Learning and reading sky. Also, there are some mythological stories. Give name to those constellations. There are so many mythological Indian and Western stories are associated with these. And also in this course, we will be discussing those stories. And definitely, we are conducting this course online. But we can do some offline course in future, like reading of a sky as well, with the help of telescope and other things. But that is when we get connected. So to get that, first of all, we will be together during this course, and we are going to discuss around 30 hours, more than 30 hours with the children. So you will learn all these things. And recently, as I mentioned earlier, what happened yesterday and even today's launch as well. Now you heard about NASA or ISRO. But SpaceX is a company entered, it's a private company now. They are sending humans to space and they are planning to shoot a movie, Hollywood movie in space.
That's correct.
In future. So, how we are getting to space? Basically, we are dreaming of going to moon, to Mars and beyond that. But we need something to go there. And that vehicle is called as launch vehicles. And we, India, are very proud with our organization, Indian Space Research Organization. We are one of the top 5 companies or organizations in the world who are working in space research. So this is the GSLV model, scale model. This is a 1:200 model you will be making. This is the ready model. Whatever you are looking on the table, they are prepared by us, but you will not get such ready-made model. You have to spend at least 1 hour at home to make these models from scratch. And that is the beauty of this course. Apart from gaining knowledge, doing things by hand is very important. The construction of few things and understanding. So when you're making the rocket, you will learn about what is the first stage, what is second stage, what is third stage, what are payloads, where satellite is placed, or when humans are going into the space, where they are sitting. So it's a 50-story building. So when you are in course, it will be a lot of fun with means learning with enjoyment.
That's correct. That's correct. So I think all of you by now know in brief what is this course going to be. Starting from basic astronomy, understanding sky, understanding constellations, rotation of earth and everything. First 6 sessions, as you know, it's a 10 session program, are dedicated to understanding of sky, because that's the foundation of so many things. Even those who want to take it up as a career, they must know basics of sky before they start talking about something like a black hole. They must know basics of it. So first 6 sessions are dedicated for this, and next 4 sessions they are given for space. So understanding different satellites, space launching vehicles, then international space labs, or some objects which are placed like Hubble telescope. So those last 4 sessions will be all about space study. The methodology is very simple. We will send you kits, 2 or 3 kits at a time, to your address by courier, by safe courier, taking care of this COVID situation. Then on every Saturday, we'll share 1 video discussing about 1 concept. For example, first video is going to be of solar system, because that is most common to all of us. So we'll talk about solar system in some 20-30 minutes video. We'll also share 1 more video for making of a model. Material is anyway given to you. What you will need is something material around you, like pencil cells or Fevicol and something like that, not more than that. So model kits are given to you. You'll make that model on Saturday or on Sunday, or you can take your own time to make that model, because videos are going to be with you forever. On Sunday afternoon, we'll have a discussion on that concept alone, because at a time we can't handle all topics together. So we'll have discussion forum for that topic alone in the afternoon. It'll be 30 to 40 minutes live session using Zoom app or Google Meet. We'll have a platform. You may ask your questions in chat box, or you can share your questions with us. Whatever we can answer right at that time, we'll answer them. Other questions will be reserved for next discussion session, because all questions may not be answered in one single session. So this is the methodology. Material comes to you, video and discussion. So very plain and simple. This will start from 29th. For those who have taken admission in last week. But I'm very happy to share with you that response is enormous, good response. We had a limit of 90 seats that is filled. Nothing to worry about. One more fresh batch will be started on 6th of December, that is next Sunday. So you can take your admission now up to end of this week, that is up to 29th. Comfortably you can take admission, but do it early. And your batch will start on 6th. Same, will continue. Method will not change. Anyone who is 10 years and above and who is comfortable to understand this discussion can join. We'll discuss in 2 languages as far as possible, English and Hindi, wherever necessary. Right, today we are talking all in English, but then we'll try to mix Hindi for those who are from other mediums. So that's how it will happen as a methodology. So those who are interested, they can, of course, Dinesh can share it with you, that how to go about, those who want to take it forward.
Yes, basically, if you want to enroll for this course, as I sir mentioned, first batch is already full and we have to announce second batch. So those who are willing to take admission and enroll today onwards will be enrolled for new batch, which is starting from 6th December. And to enroll you, you can go into the description box of this video. You will find a link in blue color. Just click on that link. You will be directed to one page where you have to fill all your details. Just click on the buy now there. Sky and Space Kit. You can see a video as well there, and 6 images where whatever things you are learning during this course. So everything is there. You write your name, address, correct address, and pay your fees using all modes, whichever are available for online transaction, and can take admission. As I said earlier, first batch is already full. So if you want to enroll for second batch, do it early, because we don't know if we can announce third batch as well. So do it early. And as I said, this will be a fantastic journey, because everyone, even this course is not only for one child in your home. Parent can also learn with the children. So this will be a family course, in my opinion.
Exactly.
So whenever you go outside, so this fees is not for one child. This fees is a fee for family.
Of course, certificate will be given only to one person. Whoever is registering with us, this course is announced by Sakar Media Group and Sunday Science School Kutuhal Group together. So certificate will also come with the same kind of names, like Sakar and Sunday Science School together will certify those who complete this course successfully.
And also, apart from these things, there will be two more discussion sessions, like the tool we have as a smartphone. Using smartphone, which softwares can be used to study or to read night sky. So we will take one session on softwares of astronomy thing, and also we will discuss which books to read for astronomy and space science, and also what are the career opportunities in astronomy and space science. Though you are too young to decide, but still India is emerging as a power in space science. And remember, don't dream to, there is no harm in dreaming to go or to become an astronaut. But mind you, everyone cannot become astronaut. But when one person goes into the space, there are 3,000 people supporting on the ground.
That's correct.
And even one of those 3,000 commit a mistake, that mission will be a failure.
That's right.
So you can, even you are in lab sitting on the ground, still the importance of you is same as of an astronaut. So there are a lot and lot of opportunities emerging in India. So we will discuss all these things in the course, and hope to see you all on aboard. Meet you soon. I think we will conclude these sessions. If you have some questions in mind, you can write in the description box here as well. And you can directly call us on our numbers. We will write down numbers in the comment box to which you can directly call us and discuss with sir and me. So don't hesitate to call us. We are always there for you, and we all love, we are doing these things 25 years, and we love to interact with children. So definitely, it for us also, when kids ask questions, it is a learning for us as well.
Yes, yes, yes. And even for parents, because the child is hidden in you as well. So all of you can join this course. And thank you for joining this live session. I hope you enjoyed that. You have learned something from us, and you will take it forward. Join us in journey of astronomy and space.
Thank you.